For the most part, I think the majority of people envisage God as a being with limitless power and resources that can do anything he wants to, whenever he wants to. But I also think far fewer people, in fact very few, actually stop to consider the sorrow and sadness and anguish that God feels over his creation. It's hard to do it justice with an illustration, but we will try to just scratch the surface in the next window. Picture a close family with a son and daughter. The parents do all they can to bring up those children well. The parents go through many sacrifices to ensure the kids get the best possible foundation to become loving, responsible adults who will grow up to be sensible and wise. But then the kids mix with the wrong people and end up going in the opposite direction, addicted to drugs, pornography, and a constant string of failed abusive relationships. And oftentimes, the parents themselves end up being abused in many ways too. Do those parents love their kids any less? Of course not. But the pain and anguish they feel inside after seeing all of their efforts unraveled within a relatively short time is devastating, because they only wanted the best for them. Can we then begin to imagine how our Abba Father feels when he bears witness to all the thoughts, words and deeds here on earth, when people deliberately ignore him, abuse him and turn their back on him, doing the exact opposite of what he says? The previous verse from Isaiah 53 verse 3 describes Jesus, the suffering servant, a man of sorrows and a direct reflection of the Father's heart. Jesus knew only too well the scope of evil at work in the world and how it affected even those who were closest to him in his earthly ministry. From Peter denying knowing him three times to being betrayed by Judas, and from his disciples falling asleep as he was praying in anguish, and the people choosing Barabbas over him who did no wrong. It paints rather an ugly picture of humanity, a picture of people who had become so disconnected from the Father's heart that they were like strangers to the one who created them. Of course Jesus knew this, which is why he came. Large numbers of people today don't want to hear about Jesus for a variety of reasons. But behind all those reasons is just one main reason. In several places in Scripture, we see where Jesus refers to Satan as the prince of this world, the prince of the power of the air, and the ruler of this world. He dared to offer Jesus all the kingdoms of the world if Jesus would bow down and worship him. He was offering those kingdoms because he controlled them. And unless we are in explicit denial, he still has those rulers and kingdoms in his pocket today. And it's no secret who they are. Today, many people, right from the top of the hierarchy to the bottom, are under Satan's control. Politicians, celebrities, music artists, business people, along with multitudes of everyday folk. Some have deliberately sold out, whilst others don't even know or care less, as long as nobody rattles the cage of their God-given conscience. Taking up our cross daily is probably the hardest thing any of us will have to do. There's nothing easy about it, and the more devotion you show to God, the more the enemy will use his influence to make life difficult for you. He will attack your family, your friends, your finances, your job, your relationships, and just about anything else which is close to your heart or important to you. Anyone who has truly been on the front lines of faith will testify that this is true. Many who have experienced these difficulties and hardships, coupled with being mocked by friends and those closest to them, have drifted away from the faith and backslidden because they just can't stand the weight of the cross on their back anymore. They sell out to the world and Satan because they just can't face the enemy onslaught. It's easier to go with the tide than against it, and it's more attractive to be popular than different to what the world says is the norm. I'm sure that many of us have stumbled off the path at some point and took a wrong turn and found ourselves in the enemy's backyard, myself included. And upon doing a U-turn to correct our mistakes can be a long and painful process, even feeling like you may never find your way back again. But let me assure you that if you use that pain and recycle it into faith to propel you forward, you will make it, and if you are paying close attention, Jesus will help you. But there again, make no mistake, the great falling away, or the great apostasy as it's often called, is already begun. So very many have fallen away already, and the numbers are increasing daily. I'm sure many of you visit TikTok, myself included, which is overflowing with so-called prophets, quote-unquote. They use prophet in the name and prophecy in the title, and are very keen on the gifters, people who give them money, or give them rewards rather, in the form of roses and animations, and regularly prompt the gifters for more. I heard one guy recently, and he's always saying, get in the gifters lane if you want more attention, get in the gifters lane, you know, like, what? And the focus of these so-called prophecies is on money, health and relationships, the things that affect people the most. And they tell people that your breakthrough is right around the corner, or in some cases within hours, especially if they sow a seed, in quotes. I would like to add that certainly not everyone on TikTok is a cash prophet, but there are many. And with a little discernment, it quickly becomes apparent who is who. Aside from TikTok, there are also those in the church who speak according to their own experiences and agenda, and not from Scripture or the Holy Spirit. And the more they do this, the more slippery the slope becomes on which they're standing on. Remembering that someone on a slippery slope goes downwards and not upwards. Over the years, I've shown examples of and spoke about the many different groups and individuals calling themselves quote-unquote Christian. But in all honesty, today, in 2024, the true church is relatively small towards what it was many years ago. And at the other end of the spectrum, amongst those who refuse to have anything to do with God or just flat out deny Him, are being homegrown, especially on campuses where indoctrination is rife and Satan rules the roost of willing servants, both young and old. Yet those same people, they have no idea how much danger they are in, with so many signs of the end of days all around us. The sold-out servants of Satan are now working overtime in the spirit of the Antichrist to try and destroy as much as they possibly can of God's creation. Those people on the satanic hierarchy are so tainted by evil, they barely qualify as humans any longer. I pity their soul on the day of the Lord, lest they truly repent. We can't really talk about specific scenarios on this platform, well, and others for that matter, because the days of free speech and expression, although still lawful, have been usurped. But those with eyes to see and ears to hear already know most of what is and has been going on. Land being bought up or seized under compulsory purchase orders, etc. I have to stop myself here because I just don't want to begin mentioning specifics as much as I'd love to. But I don't want to give the Antichrist an excuse to ban any more of my videos, just like the way they threw me out of the YouTube partner program. Of course, that had nothing whatsoever to do with this being a Christian channel. Of course not. Regular viewers and faithful subscribers will already know that I've been going through a very difficult patch for the best part of a year, becoming homeless and something of a refugee, really. But regardless, I think I'm now on the verge of getting a new place to live, so you will be seeing a lot more of me again, and I thank God for that. I still have some sizable tax debts to deal with, but I'm not going to ask you guys for help with that because you have enough problems of your own. But what I would ask you to do is to watch the trailer which comes just after this, on the end of my video, because that certainly would help me for anyone who partakes. So this is just about, it'll be a regular thing on my videos from now on, and it's just basically me doing a little bit of affiliate marketing, that's the truth. And but I'm carefully screening the products that I am promoting and making sure that they're 100%. So I'm not just promoting any old rubbish just to get some commission. So if you'd be kind enough, I would really, really appreciate it. So as always, love and blessings to you all, and I will be back with you certainly within the next couple of weeks. So with that, I'll say God bless and thank you again. Bye-bye.